right. Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to our DMACC Career Discovery events. We are excited to have a photographer with us today for our Ask a Professional series. And we thank all of you for joining us today too as well. My hope is that these events that we're putting on are linking your education and your career interests with professionals right here in Central Iowa. So before I introduce our professional, I just wanna say hello. My name is Jill Hoik and I work a part of the work-based learning team at DMACC. And so again, thank you for being on the call. I really encourage you guys to engage with him and ask him questions. You can do that by either leaving them in the chat and I can read them to him, or you can kindly unmute yourself too and ask that way. So again, thank you all for being here. Without further ado, I would love to introduce our professional today. His name is Jacob Fox and he is a photographer for Meredith Corporation. And we also have Reese Strickland on the line too. And he is the director of photography at Meredith Corporation. So thank you both for being here. We'll kind of hone in on Jacob a little bit more. He's out on location and everything today too. But again, thank you both for taking time out of your busy schedule to be with us here today. So I will ask the first question, but again, students who are logging on, please feel free to engage and ask in any way, okay? So Jacob, I know I said that you're a photographer for Meredith Corporation, but can you kind of take us back to the beginning? And is this something that you knew you always wanted to do? Is it something that just kind of you stumbled upon? And then, so kind of take us on your career journey and what led you up until where you are today. And then maybe talk about any education or training that you have too as well.
Sure, Jill. Yeah, thanks for having me. Wow. Yeah. Definitely started as a hobby. And when I was younger, I think my mom got me a camera when I was 5 and I really just loved taking pictures. It wasn't until I was probably 19 that I found a wedding photographer and I joined him, and I worked with him for quite a bit, just taking random pictures at weddings. And when I saw that first paycheck, I'm like, wow, I could really make money taking pictures. Did I know what I wanted to shoot back then? Not a clue. I just wanted to take pictures. And I love all types of photography. But I would say, yeah, I was probably 19. I started shooting weddings. And eventually I needed to learn more about how to work this camera. Cause you know, anybody can run a camera, but it's being able to be able to set, change settings and learn how to frame up a shot to find that perfect photo. And so I took a 2-year program in Omaha. It's very similar to the DMACC program that they have, which is a great program with David Purdy. But I was in Omaha for 2 years, took a commercial photography program. But I would say learning photography under photographers was how I developed all my knowledge, watching all these professionals work and day in and day out. I was an assistant for a long time and I learned a lot by watching these guys work and women for that matter too. But it just takes practice. That's what it's about, getting behind that camera, shooting day in and day out and learning different styles of photography, lighting, composition, traveling, just seeing all sorts of photography. It's not just one style. So it's been a long journey and it's been, I'm 38 now. So it's almost been 20 years that I got my first paycheck doing a photo shoot. But I would say, from a hobby to a professional now, I'm so blessed. I'm very lucky. So.
Yes. Thank you for taking us down that journey. I am, you know, Reese and I were talking about before everybody logged on, just, you know, photography in general is just really competitive right now with
Absolutely.
A lot of different equipment. And you mentioned Dave Purdy, our DMACC professor, and I've had conversations with him and his students. And one thing that they did encourage, you know, with actually going to school and learning a little bit more, like you said, about the technology is sometimes, you know, your guys is expensive equipment, right? And
yeah,
when you're doing it alone, it's kind of expensive. And so that's another benefit, I think, of, you know, going to a school that has photography is being able to
absolutely.
Use equipment, maybe that. Do you agree with that then?
Absolutely. My first camera, my grandma bought for me because they're, you know, it wasn't even the best camera. It's probably $1,500. And I was 19. I didn't have $1,500 to spend on a camera. So yeah. And that's just the camera alone. And then you have to get lenses and lights. So it all adds up. So definitely. Yeah.
Awesome.
Hey, Jill, I would say Jacob's bag here at work is somewhere around 45,000 that he carries. And that's only two cameras and a whole lot of lenses.
Yeah.
So it really is very pricey.
Yes. Wow. That's more than what I even thought. So thank you.
Adds up quick.
Yes, it does. Jacob, can you kind of walk us through what a typical day looks like? And I know when I say typical, you'll probably laugh because there's probably no typical day for you.
Sure.
You know, being a professional photographer, just kind of walk us through what a day looks like for you.
So most days I'm in the studio and there's so many varieties. I'll just give an example of some food. We shot food. So this week, I was in the studio. There's a prop stylist / art director and a food stylist on set at all times. So I show up, set up my equipment. We have to communicate with the art director and food stylist to create our first shot. And so getting there, it takes some time. We probably do 5 to 8 shots of food a day. So maybe about an hour per shot is what we spend on food. And so, you know, I get into work, set up my lights, set up all my equipment, make sure we're good to go, communicate with art directors and the food stylist to create that perfect shot. And that's just the past couple of days that we shot some food. Today is a little different because of the rain tomorrow. We had to do some rescheduling. So I'm out on location. I'm actually in my car because this is the quietest spot out here. For some reason, everybody started their lawnmower right when I was about to take this call. So I had to jump into my car. But today we're out shooting. It's actually command strips for VHG.com. And we're showing how to use a command strip on your deck with light. So it's so random. It's just so different. And today I have to get big scrims out, sandbags to set up all these equipment to block light or flag light. It's just day in and day out is so different. So, and that's what I enjoy the most is the variety about my job. It's something a little different each day. So I went from shooting food in the studio to outside on location in the sunlight. And, you know, that part I would say I love the most about my job is the variety.
Yeah. And
Jacob, talk about when you were talking about your food, you said 5 to 8 shots, but how many recipes was that? And how many shots did you shoot to get to those 5 to 8 shots?
So the 5 to 8 shots, yeah, I did mean recipes. So about 5 to 8 recipes is usually what we do. And what did you ask there, Reese?
No, that's good.
Yeah. Okay.
At 5 to 8 recipes, and then how many photos do you shoot of each recipe to get to that money shot?
I see. So we have one final shot. Yeah, but it takes, oh gosh, from 50 to 100 of me clicking the button just to get to that one shot, and that's the best thing about digital photography. And I did grow up in the time of film, and they would shoot Polaroids. But they weren't shooting 100 shots like we can with digital. So being in the digital age is definitely a plus, I would say, for photography and for everybody in that industry. Absolutely.
Yeah. What would you say has been the biggest win of your career this far?
Oh gosh, a full-time job taking pictures every day. You know, when I first started out, I was an assistant and I was happy just being around photographers, taking pictures all day. And that was just me observing. But I always wanted to be the one to, you know, shoot. I wanted to be the photographer. So when I got offered a job to be full time at Meredith to do something I've always loved to do, it was a blessing. It's a dream come true. I 20 years ago, if somebody would have told me this is where I would be, I wouldn't believe them. So I feel absolutely lucky. And so, yes, full-time job, taking pictures, doing something I love every day. That's probably the best thing, I think.
Yeah. Jake, do you have a favorite cover that you've had or something along those lines?
Oh gosh. Favorite one. I think my first one is probably my favorite because it means the most to me. You'll have to send Jill our link. And it should be on my website, but it's the top rated recipes, but it was my first cover. It's very pretty. It's a strawberry pie, but being my first cover and just seeing my name in the magazine, I think that just, it meant a lot because all the hard work that I've gone through just to get here and all the great people I've worked with, I would say that it's probably my favorite cover because it has the most meaning.
Yeah. Good question, Reese. That was a good one. What do you think are like personality traits of people who want to go into photography? Like, what are some things that you think, you know, students looking into that right now should have?
Sure, sure. I actually read that question and I really liked it. And so I had to write it down. Definitely confident. You definitely want to be confident going into your job, going into a career like this. I wrote creative. You definitely need some creativity because we work with so many different types of creative people. So you kind of want to bring your side of your creativeness. Patience. There's going to be days where we're outside right now and where the sun is getting bright. You have to be patient. We need to be able to wait for that perfect light to get our shot today. When we're shooting food, you got to be patient. We will move a fork around for 10 minutes, you know, to create that best shot. So definitely patience, dependable in a team player. I would say a team player is definitely, you need to be you want to be able to work with people as a team. You can't do this all yourself. There's too many parts, so many different aspects of the job that you have to rely on other people. So I would say, yeah. And respectful. I mean, you have to be respectful to everybody you work with. Everybody brings different ideas, different personalities. And yeah, you just want to be able to work together. So.
Yeah. I love how you led with the word confidence. I think, in this profession, there's a lot of opinions, right? And
absolutely.
So sometimes, you know, you think this is a great shot and maybe somebody else doesn't think so. And so I love that you went with confidence.
Absolutely. Yes. Definitely got to be open to everybody's opinions. Yes, for sure.
Yes. What do you find most enjoyable about your position? I feel like you've kind of touched on this, but day to day, just what are some things that you enjoy the most?
Oh gosh. Yeah. Like I said before, just being able to take pictures all day. That's probably what I love most about the job. I guess I don't know a better way to put that. We have so much fun. I wake up and I'm excited to come to work. I don't have a job where I dread going to work. I'm not going in Monday, waiting for Friday to come, you know. I'm excited every day when I get to come to work because I work with such a good team. There's so many fun people at our job. So just the environment, I would say, the environment, the variety, the people I work with, and just like I said earlier, taking pictures all day long is something I never would have thought I would be doing right now in my life. So
yeah. And on the flip side of that, what are some challenges that you face day to day? I mean, you've kind of touched on those too with the patient side of things, but any other thing that you think of like, this is so frustrating about my job?
Yeah, because you'll have those days where you think a shot's going to be nice and easy, and then it doesn't always go the way you want it to. Or like today, sunny's nice, but it's a little too bright. So you just kind of, we're kind of like, man, we got to wait for the sun to go around this tree or something like that. That's just an example. Or we're shooting ice cream and everything's perfect, and then my light will go out, you know, because it's something like that. I'm really good, knock on wood, about not breaking equipment. I've done very well at my career doing that. But there are times where you're moving quick, trying to capture a shot, and you'll bump a light and it'll tip over and break, and then everybody's waiting on you. So I guess as far as a challenge goes, just trying to be as patient as I can with things like that. But there's always going to be a little challenges in the back of my mind that I think I can overcome, but nothing I could give you a great example of, but
yeah.
Hey, Jacob, maybe talk about your COVID challenge for the last year.
COVID challenge was tough because I love staying busy day in and day out. And when COVID hit, this is for everybody. We had to shut down the studio, and just me sitting at home was a challenge. Reese was nice enough to let us come in and grab our cameras and go find stuff on our own to kind of shoot. But the biggest challenge for me was just sitting at home and not seeing anybody, not being able to take pictures and work as a group. So yeah. Oh, COVID, that has been tough times, but it's coming. We're starting to come back around now. And I feel like things are getting better. And I hope that's the direction it goes. But so COVID was a big challenge for, I think, everybody in every business. So
yeah. And do you just, either one of you, want to kind of explain a little bit more about what Meredith Corporation does? So the students on the call, maybe if they're not familiar, which I'm sure probably they are, but just kind of explain what they do and then how you guys kind of fit into that.
Reese, do you want that one? Or do you want me to take that one?
It doesn't matter. So our Meredith that we work in is primarily the publishing side of things. Between our monthly magazines, our quarterly pubs, and then we have what are called SIMs. They're specific industry magazines that they may come out. Maybe you'll see a magazine that's just on air fryers or something along those lines. What we do is we provide content for our print publications and then a little bit of our online publications. Usually there's a crossover there. And to familiarize yourself with the different magazines that we have, you could go to meredith.com, which is Meredith, and you can see that we do everything from Better Homes and Gardens to food magazines like Rachel Ray, Martha Stewart, and then we do things like InStyle, Health, Shape, Midwest Living. We have so many. And the interesting thing about Meredith is we are literally worldwide. So we have foreign publications of our print magazines. And we also have publications that are shot not only in Des Moines, Iowa, which is where we originated, but since purchasing Time Incorporated 3 years ago, we also have locations in both New York, Birmingham, Dallas, Seattle, Los Angeles. And so we have a huge gamut. We also have an avenue of, I'm sure this is a swear word around here, but tasty videos, which is the high speed recipe videos. We actually do our own versions of those for 5 to 7 brands that you can find on any one of our Instagram feeds, YouTube feeds, et cetera. And so when this is over, because Jacob's on site, what we thought we would do, we'd send you a link to Jacob's portfolio, my freelance portfolio, and then Meredith's website, so you can get a good feel of what we do here at Meredith.
Yeah, absolutely. I will send that out to all of our participants. So yes, thank you. And Reese, while I have you on the line here, since you're the director of photography, and then I have one more question and then we'll wrap up. But Reese, since you're the director of photography, what do you look for when you're looking for a photographer like Jacob? What are you looking for?
So what we need is proven results, and those proven results take time. It's interesting you ask that question. We have an opening right now for a photographer, and I would say in about 5 days I've received 75 applicants, And out of those 75 applicants, we were able to narrow that down to about eight people that really fit what we were looking for. Understanding what it is that we do, how we do it, and the importance of it is really important. There's a real disrespect in society for professional photographers versus, I would say, just people with cameras. And I was going to give Jacob an opportunity to eventually pop off, but while we're doing it, we can cover that. Jacob mentioned that he was an assistant and that he observed a lot. It's really much more than that. He traveled with photographers on set, set up their equipment, help them get to the settings where they are, watch them, run and do things for them, you know, whether that be grab a different lens or grab a different filter, or, you know, maybe it's a device like a softbox or set up a new light. So working as a photo assistant is really, really important. Jacob did that for several years. And most of our photographers here, I would say on average, work as a photo assistant to a professional like Jacob for a minimum of five to 10 years. It's a really driven process. And you have to be willing to put your ego aside. You might think you're the best photographer in the world, but you've got to work for someone that's lived it, that has done that, and then slowly build your own portfolio and be able to show proven results.
Yes. Thank you for sharing that.
To touch on that too, like Reese was saying, yes, I was an assistant for a long time, and I was really lucky. I got to work when I started at Meredith, there were six photographers, and I got to work with each one of them. So just learning a little bit from each one of them and then slowly gaining their trust. And like Reese said, setting up equipment, and then they would eventually let me frame up a shot and light it kind of how I would want to light it. I would come in early. I would stay late. I would come in on the weekends. I had no social life. This is all I was doing. And then I shot weddings on the weekends as well. So I just got behind that camera as much as I could. And then eventually developed the trust of the art directors. And I remember my first photo shoot with, so we shoot Better Homes and Gardens has product at Walmart, and we do most of the photography here in Des Moines. I remember my first photo shoot with those guys, one of the photographers, somebody had broke into their house. And so he had to leave, and whatever needed to be shot had to be shot this day. And because they knew me and trusted me, and they knew I knew what I was doing, they let me jump in there and start shooting right away. And I was, everything went well. And I think that kind of jump-started a little bit my career with that group. Of BHG Walmart, because now I still shoot with those guys, and it's still the same group. So yeah, it's just, yeah, developing all that knowledge, working with other photographers, really, it definitely helped my career. So
yeah, thank you for sharing that.
Hey Jill, real quick, for people that are listening, for the DMACC students that are online, all but one of our photo assistants currently on staff are DMACC photography program students that were referrals from David, Mr. Purdy. So if you're on this, it tells me you're interested. And if you're interested, you know, make sure that you do a good job with him, because I don't take assistants that aren't referred to me from someone. But if they're referred to me, the ones that David has referred, both from there, and there's also another program out of Cedar Falls, we put a lot of those kids to work, and some of those assistants have been here for as long as, you know, 5 years already. I know it's an assistant job, and you're not a photographer, but you're paid a pretty good wage, and the amount of information that you can learn from professionals like Jacob and our other staff photographers is astronomical. And you have to work, you don't have to get into a world like ours, you almost have to work as a professional assistant to get that opportunity to be a photographer. Impress David, and then your name will float my way, I promise.
Yes, thank you for that. And Jacob, one last question for you, and we can let you pop off. So for students, there may be some high school students on the line too, as well as our DMACC students. But for those that are, what advice would you give to young students right now? You know, like when they're in high school and thinking about maybe a profession, what is some advice that you would give them?
For photography, definitely get your hands on a camera. You know, every day you want to just go out there and shoot, just photograph, you know, develop contacts, reach out. When I moved to Omaha when I was, oh gosh, let's see, I might've been 20 at the time, 20 or 21. I looked up, this is back when they had phone books. You guys probably know about phone books, but I looked up every photographer in this phone book and I emailed or contacted them one way or another. I think there was 20 to 30 that I contacted. You just have to reach out and just to get some develop contacts. One responded to me. I'll never forget her. And I met up with her and I followed her around and she showed me it wasn't more about using the camera. It's just about talking to clients, talking to just getting to know people. And that's kind of what life is about, developing contacts. But reach out to other professionals in the field that you're interested in, and just work hard. You got to work hard. And like I said, I came in early, I stayed late, I worked on the weekends, and it all paid off. So I'm extremely blessed for that, but I'm very lucky. But I also know I worked really hard to get here. So
awesome. Well, thank you for ending on that, Jacob. We can let you pop off and get on with your day, but thank you so much again for being here with us. And I'll be sure to send all the participants today the links that you share with me.
Thanks for having me. Jake, I appreciate it. And if they have any questions, they can absolutely email me, which would be totally fine. I feel like I'm better at responding to emails than answering in person. So,
yes.
But thank you so much for having us.
Yes, thank you. And Reese, I just have a couple questions for you real quick. How did you start your journey in photography?
So mine would be a little bit different. For those of you that are interested, I started off, I was an IT guy. I was a computer software developer. And after 9/11, most of the people online were maybe not even born or very young. I lost my job as a VP out in West Des Moines Incorporate. And the only other thing I did secretively was shoot pictures. And kind of like Jacob, I really decided at that point I wasn't going back to the suit and tie world of system and development. And I just got busy and I started shooting and shooting a lot and using contacts that I had. And I would say, like Jacob, if you're not shooting every day, then it's going to be hard. I still, I'm the director of photographer at the world's largest publishing company. And I shoot every single day. When I leave here, I shoot something. I try and put something on Instagram, something on Twitter, something somewhere. And so I just started shooting a lot. And one relationship that I had was through Iowa State football. And I got an opportunity to shoot a football game. And then from there, someone saw my work and decided that they liked it. And I got an opportunity to start shooting at Wells Fargo Arena. And from there, that grew. And I started shooting for Rolling Stone Magazine and Sports Illustrated. And unlike Jacob, I don't typically shoot food and interiors. I shoot sports and music. And because of that hard work for 19 years, grinding out a living as a freelance photographer, and then having an IT background, the director, one of our VPs here was a VP at the company that I worked at 20 years ago, saw my drive and commitment and my ability to work well with people and reached out to me and said, hey, I want to bring you into Meredith and I want you to help lead our team and see how we can develop here. And Meredith is a lot different under my leadership than it was previous leadership. It's not better, it's not worse, it's just different. And we have grown. And my photographers here shoot, you know, they have 20 days a month that they're available. They shoot 19 and a half days a month. They work, they grind. You know, Jacob talked about how he looks forward to work every day. Some days that has to be hard because he shoots every day. And it's an 8-hour day. And so because of a relationship I had 20 years ago as a software developer, and then that hard work for 20 years, that relationship 20 years ago came full circle and helped me land this role here. And so when Jacob talks about relationships, Des Moines is a really small place. And I don't think sometimes our youth understand how small it is, but that relationship from 20 years ago helped me to come full circle and land the opportunity that I have. And I too am a blessed man. We are lucky to have the opportunity to work in something that we love.
Yeah. You know, I've been doing a lot of these series, and that is one thing when people are speaking professionals, you know, they talk a lot about that. Some of them know from very little that that's what they want to do, but most of them don't. It's a relationship or something similar to what you just described, Reese, of kind of, it's weird how it kind of works itself out. And so thank you for sharing that story. I think sometimes, especially in the creative world, that can be difficult, you know, like, oh, maybe I haven't always been in the industry and shifting and that type of thing. So thank you.
Yeah, I have a degree in exercise physiology. And so I stumbled on the fact that I was a creative, and I think being a creative now is a lot cooler than it was when Jacob and I were younger. And Jacob talked about reaching out to people through the phone book and any way that he could. These kids are blessed. They have Instagram, right? They have Twitter. They have a social presence to be able to not only reach out to people like Jacob and I, but also to demonstrate their skill sets. And so things, I don't know if it's easier, but it's certainly more convenient if you're driven to reach out and make contacts. So use those resources.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, students, we're going to wrap up. So if you don't have any questions, we will log off. But Reese, thank you again for helping me kind of navigate this and for your experience and expertise of sharing it with us and bringing Jacob along too. I truly appreciate it. And I will, like I said, send those links and all of that to our participants who registered for today so they can look at that and take some of the advice that you two have shared with us today. So thank you.
And we really are open to receiving emails or questions. Reach out. Absolutely. We're nice people.
Please do.
We would love it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, thank you, everybody. It looks like we had a photo two class log on today. So that will be great. So I'll get all that information out to everybody. But again, thank you, everyone, for participating today.
Cool. Bye. Thanks, Joe.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.